Brazil is the fifth largest and sixth most populous country in the world, home to over 212 million people in an area larger than the continental United States. And like any sufficiently well-known country, people have a lot of common misconceptions about it. Namely that they speak Spanish, their capital is Rio de Janeiro, and it's pronounced Rio de Janeiro. But it turns out it's actually pronounced more like Rio de Janeiro because of the dialect of Portuguese they speak, and it is not the capital of Brazil, and neither is the even larger nearby city of São Paulo. The capital is actually the inland city of Brasília, but the capital used to be Rio, so what exactly is going on here? Did Brazil just want to confuse us, or was there a reason for Brazil to move its capital to essentially the middle of nowhere? Although this part of South America of course had plenty of history before European colonization, the history of Brazil as we would recognize it today, in a sense began before it was even discovered by Europeans. To resolve and prevent future disputes between Spain and Portugal over the newly discovered lands across the Atlantic, the Treaty of Tordesillas was signed between the two kingdoms in 1494. The treaty established a meridian 370 leagues, about 2,055 kilometers, west of the Cape Verde Islands, lands to the east of which Portugal could claim, and to the west of which Spain was allowed to claim. Now, obviously, this didn't imply that Spain and Portugal owned the entirety of each hemisphere, just that they were only allowed to colonize lands and pursue ventures in their given hemispheres. As this was only 2 years after Columbus's first voyage, the New World had only barely been explored, or even been established as not being Asia. And in the late 15th century, Portugal was actually more interested in accessing the Indian Ocean by going around Africa. In 1500, however, a new land in this new world was officially discovered by a fleet led by Pedro Álvares Cabral, named after the Brazilwood tree, and discovered to be east of the meridian, meaning Portugal could claim it. As Brazil grew into a larger and larger colony, its first capital was the city of São Salvador, now just Salvador, in the state of Bahia, with both the city and the Governorate General of Brazil being founded in 1549. In 1763, however, the capital of the state of Brazil, now a state of the Portuguese Empire, was moved to Rio de Janeiro in the south. Barely a half century later though, Rio briefly served as the capital of what was now called the United Kingdom of Portugal, Brazil, and the Algarves, with the capital and royal family moving from Lisbon to Rio de Janeiro in order to avoid Napoleon. In a story you can learn a lot more about on my friend Jack Rackham's channel, Brazil ended up fighting for its independence not long after. And in 1822, while Portugal was now safe from Napoleon, Brazil had declared its independence as the Empire of Brazil, with its capital still in Rio, as it remained so through the First Brazilian Republic, the Vargas area, and into the Fourth Brazilian Republic. Huh, guess they must have misplaced the second and third ones. Okay, so Rio's still the capital, right? Well, at least that was the case until 1960, when it was moved to Brasília. Why? Okay, let's briefly switch from history mode to geography mode for a bit, so we can get a better understanding. Here, look at this map. This is a map of Brazil's population density. As you can see, while most of Brazil's population lives near the coast, the population is nonetheless still quite spread out throughout the country's coastline. Meaning having the capital in the southern city of Rio de Janeiro was seen as effectively favoring the south over the north. In addition, while the capital was located in its own special federal district within Rio, the city had also grown far too crowded for the capital. With all this in mind, Articles 2 and 3 of the Constitution of the First Brazilian Republic, signed all the way back in 1891, established two things. Each of the old provinces will form a state, and the old neutral municipality will constitute the federal district, continuing to be the capital of the union, until the provisions of the following article are implemented. An area of 14,400 square kilometers belongs to the union, in the central plateau of the republic, which will be demarcated in due time to establish the future federal capital. Basically, translating Google Translate here, the provinces are now states, and the old district within Rio would remain the federal district until a new one near the center of the country could be established. In the 1955 presidential election, Juscelino Kubitschek was elected on a platform based on rapid economic development, epitomized by a slogan, 50 years in 5, namely in two initiatives, the Plano de Metas, or Plan of Goals, aiming to open up and modernize the Brazilian economy, including through the other initiative, finally moving the capital. As previously established in 1922, the new capital would be located in a special federal district carved out from the state of Goiás and Brazil's center-west region, located in a previously underdeveloped region known as the Cerrado. The Cerrado, named after the Portuguese word for closed, had been essentially an agricultural dead zone, mostly limited to beef production. Although the area has since become an agricultural powerhouse, thanks to a mixture of phosphorus and lime, moving the country's capital to the Cerrado attracted many to the region, with the surrounding state of Goiás alone growing nearly threefold from 1950 to 1980. Brasilia, like America's Washington DC or Australia's Canberra, was a planned capital city created virtually from scratch. With an ideal location already selected, a public contest was held in 1957 for various Brazilian architects and city planners to put forth designs for how the city would be planned. The international jury eventually selected Lúcio Costa's plan for the city, with the main avenues forming a sort of irregular cross shape, resembling that of an airplane or a dragonfly, with the residential areas along the wings and the commercial and government buildings, many of which designed by Oscar Niemeyer, along the body. Many also found symbolism in the design, which could be said to resemble the bows and arrows used by Brazil's native inhabitants, the cross of the Portuguese who colonized the area, or the shape of the airplanes connecting Brazil's cities to each other and the rest of the modern world. The idea of moving the capital to a newly built ultra-modern city in what was essentially the middle of nowhere, however, had mixed reactions. While supporters praised the construction of Brasilia as a symbol of Brazil's coming of age, in contrast to the older colonial cities along the coast, its critics saw the construction of this new capital as little more than savvy political maneuvering, which would not solve more pressing issues like poverty and corruption. Nonetheless, construction of the city, or at least the first phase of it, only took around 3 years, completing in April 1960 with the completion of Costa's plans for the city, and temporary construction camps the workers basically refused to tear down, which, alongside other such neighborhoods, now provide a means of cheap housing just outside the city center. Brasilia was intended to be a modern city, and as such, the city was very clearly built for the car, with many today feeling as if it were not meant for a human scale. And to this day, many prefer to have fun in Rio or Sao Paulo instead, as many criticize the city as not really feeling like a city. Today, the federal district that houses Brasilia is the third largest metro area in Brazil, with a population of 4.2 million, only beaten by the absolute titans that are Rio de Janeiro and Sao Paulo. The city has experienced growing pains with both the issues mentioned earlier and being said to have been too successful, with the population having grown extremely rapidly. Perhaps only time will truly tell how Brasilia will continue to form as a city.